Hello there, it's Adrian here again, and I thought it was about time we looked at another song, and in particular that we looked at a song that uses our new G and C chords. So the song I've chosen is called California Stars. It's by Wilco and Billy Bragg, actually based on some old Woody Guthrie lyrics. It's a really great and quite easy to play beginner's song. If you don't know it already, you should definitely check it out. Let me play a bit of the song for you now, and then I'll take you through it.
I'd like to rest my heavy head tonight on a bed of California stars. I'd like to lay my weary bones tonight on a bed of California stars. I'd like to feel your hand touching mine. Tell me why I must keep working on. Yeah, I give my life to lay my head tonight on a bed of California stars.
This is a really nice song by one of my favourite bands, and in many ways it's a very simple song to learn. We just need three chords, G, C and D. We already know those chords, and we're going to play them in the same pattern over and over for the entire song. Let me show you that pattern now. We're going to be starting on a G chord, and we want two bars of G. Then we've got two bars of D, two bars of C, and then we're back to G again for another two bars. That's it. That's the entire chord pattern. That's one verse of the song. For all the other verses, we're just going to play the same pattern. I think there's probably an instrumental section as well. Just going to play the same chords, but obviously we're not going to be singing. So let's have a play through that chord progression. If we hold down a G chord, like with the other song we learned, I want to keep the right hand very simple in the beginning while we're getting the basic song together. Then we can always make that more interesting once we've got the basics. So starting on G, we've got two bars. So we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Well, then we're changing to D. Two bars. 4, 1, 2, 3. Change to C. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, and change to G again. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the pattern. Then we go around again, starting on G, and repeat the whole pattern. Take it as slowly as you need to start with, concentrating on nice, smooth changes. Let me just play that one more time. I'll sing a few of the words and you can see how those fit in. We've got, I'd like to rest, G, my heavy head tonight on a bed. Change to D, of California stars. C, I'd like to lay my weary bones tonight on a bed. Back to G, of California stars. I'd like to feel. Then we start the next verse there with another two bars of G. So get comfortable with that. Works pretty well, sounds good playing it very simply. Will sound even better if we make the right hand a bit more interesting. The pattern I would suggest is this one. Let's go down, 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 up, down, up. Not quite like the patterns we've looked at so far, but it's no more difficult than any of the other strumming patterns. It's down, 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 up, down, up. We're going to count that 1, 2, 3, and 4. And so it's a one bar pattern. We're going to play that twice on each chord. And that will sound like this. G. To D. And C. Back to G. Works really well for this song. If I it up a bit. Be a good time now just to point out a little trick, I suppose, that will help you to change from one chord to another a bit more quickly and a bit more smoothly. And the trick is this: we're going to leave the previous chord just a tiny bit early to get to the new chord in time. The most important thing when you're playing in time and you're trying to establish a groove is to get to the new chord in time, even if that means leaving the previous chord a little bit early. In practice, that's going to mean on the beat four, or on the and of four, our fingers are going to be in the air and on their way to the new chord. Our right hand is still going to be moving, still going to be strumming, and we will hear just some open string noise in that gap. But because it's flashing by so quickly, the ear isn't going to notice that open string noise, and it's actually going to help knit the two chords together. Let me demonstrate that and hopefully make it a bit clearer to you. If we're going from a G chord to a D chord, remember we had down, 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 up on the G chord. And we're going to go to D, down, down, up, down, up. On the last up strum in the bar, that is on the and of four, my fingers are already going to be on their way to the D chord. So let's just watch that in slow motion. We've got one, two, three, and four, and one, two, three, and four, and. Did you see that? Just on the and, my fingers were in the air and you heard that open string. It sounds a bit weird when it's slowed right down like that, but when you play it quickly, you'll hear how smooth the chord change sounds. It's do that for every chord change in this song. So G, 1, 2, 3 and four, and 1, 2, 3 and four, and 1, 2, 3 and four, and 1. And you can hear how smooth that makes the song. I think it's something that a lot of players do instinctively anyway, but it's well worth being aware of it as a beginner, and you could well find that it makes your chord changes a lot smoother. Just before I go, the eagle-eyed viewers amongst you might have noticed that when I was singing the song earlier on, I was using one of these, which is a capo. And if you don't know what a capo is, it's like a little clip which you put over the strings of your guitar, and it makes everything sound a little bit higher. Now, you don't have to have one of these to play the song. You can learn the song exactly as I showed it to you just now without a capo, and it sounds absolutely great. But if you want to be faithful to the original recording and to the way that Wilco play it, then you can get yourself one of these, put it on your guitar at the second fret. And essentially what you've done is shorten the neck of the guitar. Where the capo is, that's now become the new zero fret. And here is now the first fret, this has become the second fret, this has become the third fret. The beauty of it is the left hand doesn't have to do anything different. We can still play the same G, the same D, and the same C shapes, but everything is sounding a bit higher. And it's something that a lot of singers and songwriters use, primarily I think because it's an easy way to change the key of a song to get it to suit your voice. And you can put the capo anywhere you want on the guitar. You can experiment with it a little bit. As I said, Wilco have it at the second fret for this song, but maybe if you're a girl singer, you might want to put the capo up in the neck a bit higher to get it into a key that suits your voice. So, well, enjoy playing this song, and I'll see you again for another lesson really soon.